Hello everyone, how's it going? Dr. Incompetent here, and let's play K2, the digital edition of the card game, board game. I've never actually played it myself, but from the screenshots, it looked awesome. I love tabletop board games. I love card games, and I'm really interested to see what this game is like in its implementation. Now, this is early access, so bear that in mind. And I'm going to go ahead here and just fire up the tutorial to learn how to play. So you see the path up the mountain looks very much like a roguelike decision-making path where, you know, like Slay the Spire or Darkest Dungeon 2, we've got to make decisions on which way to go based on our deck and resources. So let's see. Let's start. You are a leader of an expedition to K2. Try to guide your two climbers. Good luck. I will lead my team and keep them alive. Jeez, I hope so. Okay. So the game goal, get as many victory points as possible. Each climber can get them when entering spaces marked with the kind of yellow symbol with a number, and you can reach the summit, but staying alive is more important. Got it. Okay, that makes sense. Movement cards. First day of the 18-day expedition. We need to move forward. You can use cards with the feet icon to move one of your two climbers. Select three movement cards. All right, so I need to select three cards. Here's my hand. And right away, I don't know. I haven't played a mountain climbing game before, so that's really interesting. I love the art style of the game. And let's see. I don't see a reason not to move. Use my highest value movement cards first. So I can go here. Some places are difficult to reach and take longer to get there. Movements can cost from 1 to 3 movement per space. Got it. Okay, so I'm going to select this one and this one. And I'm just using the mouse here and clicking on them. And I guess this one. And it'll tell me, based on these, it looks like it's highlighting which, you know, destination I can have. And I will confirm this in the bottom right. You can see, there's a score maybe in the upper left for the training expedition. Over here, there's the weather and what day out of 18 on our journey we're on. So we're going to confirm this. And it says, move climber. We have the power to reach the summit, waiting for orders. Choose the space to move the climber. So looking at this, and you can use the right mouse button to kind of drag around. You can also use WASD to look around. I like the idea. This one looks like it's higher up. There's a number that's next to this. It's like 4 up and 1 down. I don't know if that has to do with elevation. I'm just going to go up here. And then, like, you could go down this way and then move over on this path. And I don't know what all these different options are. I don't know what these, like, if these are more people to find, if this is more dangerous, but that's what I did. And confirm end of day. Okay, so this is, Mike is here, and this is where we moved Mike, right here. Planning phase, select three cards. It's important to keep our health in mind. Each climber has health points, I see that, represented by the circular blue number, and the max value is 6. Mike only has 2 health points, which is not very many. Okay. Health cards. Use oxygen resources wisely. We have a limited number of them. You can use cards with the blue circle and the number to add health points to your climbers. Choose at least one health card. So they're limited resources, but I mean, it's like, why not get them all the way up to 6 if we can? So I'm going to select this one and this one. And those are all the only ones that I have. This is like, he's chilling on this right here. He's looking with binoculars. And then I'll just get rid of a low movement card. So this is probably a way to just cycle cards that you don't need. And we will confirm this. Now it looks like right here, I'm going to gain some oxygen. I hope I go up +3, but I don't know if that's, if it only takes your highest one into consideration. Let's see here. We need to increase our Acclimatization before summit push. Some spaces add health points every turn. End this round with a climber on this square to get extra health points. Oh, okay. Use the health card or move the climber. All right, so we just say got it. And I did play movement, so I could move, but I'd want to acclimatize before I go higher to the altitude that I'm at, and it'll give me extra health points. And so I don't know if I need to move here to actually get the victory point, or if I will get that next turn, or if they're saying, no, it only triggers this turn that you'll get this victory point because it's like a special condition because you're pushing yourself up here. But I'm going to skip. Oh, no, use health card or move climber. Use this one. Okay, I use this. Okay, I could use all of them. You just click on the cards. Okay, and then now it's the choice of do I want to move or do I want to stay? And if I stay, I'll get all six health. So I'm going to just try that. You just skip the remaining actions. If you did not mean to, you can undo. If intended, confirm, and then end the turn. Okay. By the way, they're still updating the game. This team is not native English speakers, so they're working on the translation. It's fine to me so far, but just worth pointing out if you see some typos and stuff. Okay, I'm going to say end game. Or end day. Not end game. Oh, my goodness. Okay. Special movement cards. Moving down along prepared ropes is faster than climbing up. Some movement cards have two values, up and down. Oh, okay, that's interesting. So you can go up or down. Got it. So if I did this, it'd be faster, but no. I think I want to go three. And then I'm going to try this and this. And I'm going to confirm. All right. Health modifiers. We need to watch out where we stay for a night. Oh, these are all hard. Some spaces subtract health points every turn. Okay, got it. So in this case, where do we want to go? Move, climber, or pitch the tent? We're going to move. Now, looks like I get victory points for moving to all of these squares, but do I want to stop right now? Is this the highest I can get? Like, I could go all the way up here and get three victory points, and I don't see any other special squares. So what happens if I go up here? Now, you will see that, like, this, if I would have gone over here, I got three victory points for moving that. So you don't get victory points for passing through. You just get it for landing there. I could have gone this way. And the advantage is you lose it. The disadvantage is you lose a health point, it looks like. But the advantage is this is an easier climb up here, which is why it only costs two movement. So this is kind of a grueling climb to do this. But I'm okay with this. And we can move the climber or pitch the tent, which means I could actually go down if I wanted to, but I don't want to pitch a tent, or I don't want to. Oh my god. Okay, I didn't realize, I forgot about Monique. Oh dear, Monique, I have been leaving you behind. I was like, thought they were, for some reason, because they were next to each other, I thought they were on the same team. Each climber scores victory points associated to the highest visited space. Even if you go back, you keep the points. If you lose, if they die, you lose it all. Okay, so Monique needs to move. So we need to move Monique as much as possible. And then that's a little bit. So she's going slow. So we'll end the day. Weather. Look at the forecast. Oh, it's a dangerous day. The weather's about to break. Let's watch out for it. Some zones could be affected by the weather. Oh, you could see like the cross sections of the mountain reflect which is affected by the mountain. So it's actually this middle zone that my big boy is in that's being affected, but Monique is okay where she's at. All right, so Monique, we're going to select movement. Sure, her health is at 4. I think she's fine. I'm just going to select all movement cards right now. And then you see Monique, we can move her up now. If I Yeah, you can push tab. That's perfect to switch between them. I could have Mike, like, move up, but you'll notice that this is a double damage square. So I'm just going to have Mike chill. He is taking damage here because of the weather system, but we can't get up here. So I'm going to concentrate on moving Monique because I forgot to move her. So let's just move Monique, you know, as far as she can go, which is up here. And we will end the turn. And she will get a health point for chilling. And this is the planning phase. Select three out of the last six, and we will reshuffle in two rounds. Okay, so this is three health restoration, which is good, but we don't really need that at the moment. I want movement, and I'll take this just because it's a powerful card. And let me see how we're doing. So I can move Monique all the way up here. And I will. I kind of want to catch her up. I don't want to leave her behind. And then we're done moving. Mike can go down if we want. But we can also just have Mike, you know, restore health. Which this is kind of overkill. But it's fine. And then we're not going to move. So we're just going to skip. And end the day. Alright, so he's topped off. Ooh, there's really bad weather. It's 2 damage, this weather, on this. So we need to try to move everyone up as fast as possible. Select the last 3 cards, and the deck will be reshuffled. Okay, so we don't want any of these cards. Oh, yeah, I have to select 3. Okay. Pitch tents. Oh, I forgot about... I didn't know that action. You can build tents to help your climbers. Each climber carries 1 tent. Okay, so the cost is equal to the space, and it adds health. Okay, so if you're, like, about to die, you can pitch the tent. It also shows you, like, the incoming damage that you're about to suffer, which is kind of cool. Now, we're both really, really high on health. She can move down. We could move her down so she takes no damage, actually. So she's, like, safe right here. And then... we can have Mike use a health card. There's no real reason to use this health card. I guess it just gets rid of it. And then we're going to end the day. Okay. So we want to select 3 cards. I want movement. And there's the weather is great except for at the summit. So I'm going to just select all the movement I can. Nobody needs to heal. And I'm going to have Mike. He can move here. This is going to damage him. But he gets a bunch of victory points. And then Monique. Oh, okay. That was a 2 climb. All right. So we'll end the day. Unlocked. Altitude sickness defeated. End the turn above 7,000 and stay alive. Wow, okay, so we got an achievement. One more thing. There is one more mechanic not present in the tutorial. The full game includes weakness points to represent some of the challenges of mountain climbing. And they'll explain it in the next game. Okay, makes sense. Not too much overwhelming right now. So I'm going to get a bunch of movement for Monique. And I might have Mike pitch a tent. All right, so Monique can move all the way up here. And then I'm going to actually just pitch the tent. He's got one. The weather's bad, so let's just have him pitch the tent, and we'll end the day. So he's actually down to 2 health, which is terrifying. And there's no safe spaces left anymore. It's all going to damage him. So we'll take this for Monique. She still can't move up this. We'll take this. And we'll take this to keep so that Mike can stabilize. All right. And then so Monique, I'm going to have you move this is as far as she can move, is right here. But we'll still do it anyway. And Mike is going to heal up. And we'll end the day. Okay, no bad weather. Great. And we're going to have Mike recuperate. This is +3 and no bad... There's only the stress of being so high is going to hit him. Monique can climb with a 2. And nobody can get anywhere unless we get a 2. So we're just going to take a 1. Confirm. You know, like, I was thinking you should move them equally, but maybe it's a better idea to just have one, like, move them one at a time. Not sure. Alright, so Mike's going to heal. And Monique can heal. And then Monique can move, Oh, why can't Monique move right here? Maybe they can't be on the same space. Okay. I see. So there's only one person who can be at that space. Okay, good to know. I thought they could... Alright, well then I kind of wasted a turn. Monique could go down. And she wouldn't take damage, which is kind of cool, but then we'd need 3 movement points, so we're just going to skip and end the day. Of these 3 cards, I want 2 movement, I want 2 heal. These are really bad. Alright, Mike, can we get you up the mountain? He can move here. This square does actually sustain some health. So Monique... We could try to go around. I'm going to move Mike. I'm just going to keep making progress, and then I'm going to heal with Monique. Alright. God, these 3 cards are so bad. I don't want any of them. Alright, so Monique can move, but this is a terrible square right now. I will move Mike, but, well, it would take 3 movement points to pitch a tent there, or 2 movement points to pitch a tent here, but he already used his tent. I'm going to move Mike, even though we're going to take a ton of damage right here. That doesn't really do anything for you, but... Whatever. Okay. So Mike needs to not die. And these are dangerous squares. So we're going to select health for Mike. And a double move for Monique. So Mike can heal. And Mike can heal. And then Monique will move up to here. Okay. And then now... I want a 3 move for sure. This is a terribly dangerous square. The weather is terrible. I'm going to take 2 move for Monique so that she can camp. Mike is actually dead no matter what happens. I can't summit. Oh, God. I'm sorry, Mike. Oh, I thought I left her enough to, here, wait. Pitch a tent. Oh, there's already a tent there. Okay. That's why it's restoring health. It's a permanent installation. Okay. Then actually, she stays alive longer if she stays here, but, okay. I mean, I don't have anything I can do. Mike dies. So what I learned was that basically maybe you need to go down. You know, it's really hard to like determine if you're going to draw the card you need to get the oxygen that you require. So restoration is really important. Moving of 2 is great. And we'll take a restoration. All right, so You can heal, and you can go up here, and then you can heal. All right, so the weather is bad. Let's just take as much movement as we can. All right, and we don't have enough movement points, so we'll just end the day. All right, okay, this is great. We can actually summon. She will die, though. if I summon. So what we're going to... I think what I should be doing is sandbagging cards and not using them. I don't know if you discard them all, but I'm going to take them. And then I'm going to pitch to 10. And then... I'm going to end the day. Pitch 2 cents and 10 cents in the same game. Cool. Alright, so what I need to do now is... Last day of the expedition. Well, we're going to die anyway. I actually will not die if I stay here. So we didn't make it. We got 6 points. But we finished the tutorial, so we know a little bit more how to play. Now, when we start the game, they will introduce the other mechanics. And I gotta say, like, I did... At first, I was like, oh, this is pretty simple. No, I ran out of time, and I was actually... What I thought was racing them to the top. So I need to do a much better job at moving them and figuring out how to dance around the weather, how to restore health, how to deal with clunker cards in the deck. And it just comes from learning the game and understanding, you know, when to move and when to go down and on and on. So I'd love to know what you guys think of the game so far. What are your impressions as you see this? I have a lot to learn, but I really enjoy the challenge and I can't wait to try again. Let me know your opinions in the comments below. I'm going to put a link to the Steam page for the game so you can follow it and see it as it develops. Thanks so much for watching. Take care.